you know, if you've got a new startup, one of the issues is just getting attention. You can't sell to customers that don't know you exist. You can't partner with companies that don't know you exist. So by having this focal point plugged into an ecosystem already interested in our clusters, you get an acceleration for the companies that are located there.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. Joining me is Neil Crabb, CEO of Frontier IP Group. Neil, very good to speak with you. You've announced a strategic partnership with Abstract Securities. What does the partnership cover?
So it's us being the anchor tenant in a new science center that they're establishing of just under 140,000 square feet. We're taking 18,000 square feet within that. The rationale for us doing that is that it is clear that the portfolio companies and indeed wider companies in Cambridge, startups in Cambridge, would benefit from really high quality space, but also potentially as well access to the wider Frontier services and the team. And we can deliver that more effectively if we do that in a concentrated format by having companies on a single location. The lab space in Cambridge, I think it was a Savills report saying it's about 97% used. So clearly there is a supply and demand imbalance currently anyway. But also some of that space is not of the right specification. So having, if you've got world-class research, you need world-class facilities. And we think we can help deliver that from a financial point of view as well, of course, because we're the first tenant in, it's favorable terms that we've been offered, including £1 million upfront support, and we're actively engaging on the fit out because it is brand new space, so it's genuinely going to be best in breed for companies that are moving in there, as well as part of the process.
Can you expand more on why Frontier IP is doing this?
Yes, so within the clusters that we're already focused on, we are building up an ecosystem of partners, funders, the expertise within our own team. And this allows more efficient delivery of that. I would say that by having companies together that are of like mind, addressing like challenges, you get a positive interaction. It reduces the friction in setting up startups. And remember, most of what we're focused on is early stage companies coming out of university. There are lots of studies that show that companies spend a disproportionate amount of their time in their early phase in this setup element. And if we can help and smooth that, that lets them focus on the thing that is commercially relevant and technically relevant rather than just the day-to-day, if you like. It gives us more time to interact. And as I say, the ecosystem element, it creates a focal point for us to interact with our partners, be they funders, industrial partners. They can perhaps come and see several companies at once, where they wouldn't make the effort to travel to see just one. So you build that relationship over time. And then finally, it's a really good way to showcase the technologies. And you know, if you've got a new startup, one of the issues is just getting attention. You can't sell to customers that don't know you exist. You can't partner with companies that don't know you exist. So by having this focal point plugged into an ecosystem already interested in our clusters, you get an acceleration for the companies that are located there.
Neil, how it will help portfolio companies not based in the center?
Yeah, so picking up on that point, because we've enriched the ecosystem, that is still going to be available to companies that are not on site, that they can be plugged in as well and connected. We've had some experience also of this previously. So for example, at our Duxford site, we organized a capital markets day where we brought on board a lot of investors and industrial partners and brought all the companies together. And we've done the same in Portugal previously. The challenge is that it turns into a major production effort when you're using a third-party site coordinating. You can only do it at scale for lots of companies. Here, this will just be a regular part of the business process with much more frequent interactions. And I see the external companies benefiting from that as well. So it allows us to enable them to build relationships. It's also the case, obviously, that you know, the sort of golden triangle area, a disproportionate amount of the money and of the partnering and of the big companies you want to interact with are based there. So it gives a format that if you're external, you can come in and we can host presentations or whatever to accelerate the interaction with industrial partners.
How do you see the center developing, Neil?
So if you look at it from the point of view of the journey of an individual company, if they're successful, they may well want to expand. You know, we talk about getting companies to inflection points. So we help them at the start, but with the view that they become fully independent. Well, being on that science center where more space is both available now and yet more is being built in the second phase means that they're able to move on. And obviously we have a good relationship with Abstract that potentially that they can non-disruptively expand the capacity of what they're doing, moving on to wider spaces. I think it will enrich the depth of relations that we have with ecosystem partners. And again, that's all part of what we're about in acceleration. So the more we do this, the greater the throughput, the better those relationships are going to be. I hope as well that it will allow us to showcase the companies. And again, once people get used to coming, then I hope this will be an item they're diarizing to maybe come every 6 months or 12 months to see what's there. And again, just raising the profile. We always say to portfolio companies, you can't sell to customers that you don't know exist. And the same is true of investors, that actually you need to put yourself in the shop window. If you're a startup, you're striving for attention, and this is a way of helping you to get that.
Neil, any further updates from across the portfolio?
Yeah, so we saw, and I know you've done an interview already with Lucid announcing their second European distributor earlier in the week. Actually, they're a good example of we've already taken their tiles and they've got into part of the science center, not just our bit, but the wider building. So that showcase element is a very initial example of how that is going to work. They are also rolling out further with TOPS and such like, and making good progress. And I think they've said publicly, they're looking at public market options in line with the progress that they are making. So we're very encouraged by them. 2D Photonics obviously recently raised a large amount of money and is getting on with deploying that and scaling up. So watch for more news there. I think this center in itself will generate some news flow going forward as well, by the way, as we'll update the market as companies move in and we can talk about that. We are watching very much for news from Pulsive, from Nandi. From several of the others, we're at that inflection point of commercial rollout, and I think people should look for updates on those as well. And obviously, this wider space will probably allow us to selectively add. While we'll take in companies that are both core portfolio companies and others, I think this does provide a route to adding in more companies to the core portfolio.
Well, Neil, I hope you'll continue to keep us updated with your progress. Thank you very much for speaking with us today.
Thank you.
Neil Crabb, CEO of Frontier IP Group.